Hi, this is section 2.1 in Math 1114. It's about addition of matrices and scalar multiplication of matrices. I think you'll find this section to be very logical. You'll have to do a few problems to practice, but it's not as bad as, say, Gauss-Jordan elimination or anything. Section 2.1, addition of matrices and scalar multiplication. We start with some notation. You'll often see the symbol A equals A sub ij, little a sub ij. What that's really referring to is this giant matrix made up of the entries of A. Each is denoted by subscripts, and the subscripts are row and then column. So for example, A sub 3,2 is in the third row, second column, whereas A sub 1,3 is in the first row, third column. You'll notice that this is an m by n matrix because the last entry is A sub mn. And that means there are m rows and n columns. In order to add matrices, add corresponding entries. This is probably just exactly what you would have predicted. Let's take a look at an example. If I have my favorite matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, plus the matrix 0, negative 2, 3, 8, both 2 by 2 matrices, to add those matrices together, I would add the 1 and the 0, the 2 and the negative 2, the 3 and the 3, and the 4 and the 8. And so just as you probably would have guessed, I get 1, 0, 6, 12. Note, matrices must be the same size for addition to be defined. Otherwise, there aren't going to be corresponding entries. Also, the sum is going to be the same size as the matrices that you were originally working with. And if the two matrices aren't the same size, we say the operation is undefined. If this happens to be a multiple choice test or a multiple choice quiz, you would need to choose, in that case, undefined, or we can't do this, or something like that. That choice would be there. Looking at another example, here we have two 3 by 2 matrices. There are 3 rows and 2 columns. Again, to add these, we add corresponding entries. The 1 and the 0, the other 0 and the 2, negative 2 and 11, 5 and 5, negative 4 and 1, and the 3 and the 9. And that gives us the matrix with the first row 1, 2, second row 9, 10, and third row negative 3, 12. What if you were asked to do this matrix, these two matrices? The first is a 2 by 2, the second is a 2 by 3. Can I add those? No. The sum is undefined. The matrices must be the same size in order to be able to add them. To multiply a matrix by a scalar, multiply each entry in the matrix by the scalar. Again, probably what you would have predicted. It's called a scalar, by the way. It's a constant. It's called a scalar because when you multiply by a constant, that often changes the scale of what you're working on. So, a scalar, a constant, it's the same thing. A scalar is just a constant that you're multiplying by. Let's look at an example here. Here I have 2 times the matrix consisting of first row 1, negative 4, negative 5, and second row 2, 3, 4. Just as you would have predicted, you multiply every entry in that matrix by 2. That gives us the first row 2, negative 8, negative 10, second row 4, 6, 8. We can combine these ideas to do subtraction or to do problems with multiple steps. Here's a problem that has both multiplication and subtraction in it. If you remember your old order of operations, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, where P is parentheses, E is exponents, M and D are multiplication, division, A and S are addition, subtraction. We're supposed to do multiplication and division before we do addition and subtraction. So we should do the 2 times the first matrix, and either 4 times the next matrix, leaving a minus in front, or negative 4 times the second matrix with a positive or a plus in front. I chose to do 2 times the first matrix, and then I chose to do negative 4 times the second, which gave me a plus in between. At that point, you want to add the corresponding entries again. So the 2 and the 0, the 0, 0, negative 4, negative 4, 8, negative 4, etc. And you'll get 2, 0, negative 8 as your first row, 4, 2, negative 2 as your second row, and negative 10, negative 8, positive 16 as your third. So just remember to do multiplication before addition and subtraction, unless there are parentheses involved. There are also some properties in this section. If A, B, and C are M by N matrices, so they're all the same size, and R and S are scalars, so R and S are constants. A plus B is equal to B plus A. Just like with real numbers, if you add 2 real numbers, 2 plus 3, that's the same as 3 plus 2. The same applies to matrices. That was called the commutative property of addition. And that does apply to matrices. Another property that we have is the associative property. You're able to add A and B first and then C, or add B and C first and then A. You're reassociating the matrices. That was also a property of real numbers that applies to matrices. This is one of the forms of the distributive property. Here I have 2 numbers that are being added together, and then the sum is multiplied times a matrix. Instead, I could choose to distribute the matrix to each of the 2 numbers. So I would get R plus S quantity times A is equal to RA plus SA. A similar but slightly different property, it's still one of the distributive properties, is if I have 2 matrices added together and then multiplied by a constant, I could instead distribute the constant to each of the matrices and then add. This is another form of the associative property of multiplication. Here I have 2 real numbers, 2 constants, R and S, that are multiplied together and then times A. I could instead multiply S times A and then times R. So I can reassociate the numbers. Next, we're going to look at a slightly more difficult example. The properties that you just saw enable us to add and subtract matrices from equations, as well as we can multiply and divide by numbers. So here I have 3A minus 2B is equal to C, and I'm supposed to find A. They give me B, they give me C. B and C are both 2 by 2 matrices. B is 2, negative 5, 1, 0, and C is 4, 3, negative 2, 1. To find A, the easiest way is to solve for A in that equation. So take your 3A out so that you'd have 3A equal to C plus 2B. In other words, add 2B to each side of that equation. Then divide by 3, which is the same as multiplying by 1/3. Now I have A solved for, and since I know C and 2B, then it's just a matter of plugging in those 2 matrices. So A is 1/3 C plus 2B. I plugged in C, I plugged in 2B. You want to multiply 2 times B first, and then add the corresponding entries. In the end, you'll come up with 1/3 times 8, negative 7, 0, 1. Now multiply by 1/3, and we have what A is. 8/3, negative 7/3 in the first row, second row, 0, 1/3. Not too difficult because we did a little bit of algebra at the beginning. Next example. Here we have A plus B is equal to C, and A minus B is equal to D. We're supposed to find A and B if they give us C and D. For C, they give us the matrix with 2, 1 as the first row, negative 3, 4 as the second. D is 4, negative 5 as the first row, negative 1, negative 2 as the second row. The key here again is that I can add and subtract matrices. I can also multiply and divide by numbers. So if I take my A plus B equal to C, and my A minus B equal to D, and I add those, you'll notice that's good old algebra 1, where you add two equations together to get a third equation. Here, my B's are eliminated. I just have 2A is equal to C plus D. Most of the problems that you'll see will be similar. You might have to subtract the two matrices instead of adding them, subtract the two equations instead of adding them. You may have to multiply one of them by a number, but in most cases it'll work out pretty easily. Next, I just want to get A by itself. A is 1/2 of C plus D. Since A is 1/2 of C plus D, and I know C and D, I then plug in C and D, add the corresponding entries again, since that's in parentheses. So I got 6, negative 4, negative 4, 2, and I want to multiply that by 1/2. So I got 3, negative 2 in the first row, negative 2, 1 in the second. That's my A matrix. I was also looking for B. Well, since A plus B is equal to C, that was one of the original equations you were given, then B is equal to C minus A. I know C. I just found A. So I plug in C. I plug in the A that I found. And now subtract corresponding entries. 2 minus 3, 1 minus negative 2, negative 3 minus negative 2, and 4 minus 1. So I get that B is equal to negative 1, 3, negative 1, 3. So we found A, which is 3, negative 2, negative 2, 1, and B, which is negative 1, 3, negative 1, 3. I could now check the original two equations, A plus B is equal to C, and A minus B is equal to D, using the C and the D that they gave me originally. That concludes section 2.1. You will need to practice a little bit on the problems with the algebra. Be sure to do some homework problems, maybe do a practice quiz a few times, and everything should be fine.